Hi, this is Ryan Brown from mockquestions.com. In this video, we'll discuss 5 computer hardware engineer interview questions from our website. We'll go over each question and some advice on how to answer them, along with an answer example. Afterwards, if you found this video helpful, please like and share. That would mean a lot to us. Okay, let's get started. Question number 1. Tell me about an unsuccessful problem you faced and why you couldn't complete it. Unfortunately, we all fail from time to time, even though we don't like admitting it. Interviewers know this and are likely to ask about your failures during an interview. What they are looking for you to admit that you failed, take responsibility for the failure, and describe what you learned. While it's hard to admit, I failed several times during my career. One of the more recent failures was when I was assigned to develop a more efficient enclosure for our company's new computing device. Even though enclosures were not my main area of expertise, I accepted the assignment with the idea that I could learn the skills needed to complete the task. Unfortunately, the enclosure I developed did not allow the fan and heat sinks to properly cool the system. The project was turned over to somebody with more experience in this area. What I learned was to acknowledge my lack of experience and skills required to complete an assignment early so that my management team could either reassign the project or provide me with the training needed to complete the job. Question number 2. Can you walk me through what you do as a hardware engineer daily? The interviewer will ask you this question to better understand how you view this role, the task you typically perform, and the accomplishments you focus on. They are also interested in determining if your perspective of the job aligns with that of the organization. Hardware engineers perform a wide variety of tasks, and no 2 days are alike. However, there are some typical tasks that I regularly work on. These include creating designs for computer hardware, verifying my design using different testing procedures, identifying any defects in the design, correcting them, and creating cost estimates for the hardware production. My other activities involve supervising junior team members, documenting the work, creating manuals for the support organization, and attending periodic training. The balance of my time is spent collaborating with other project stakeholders to ensure that the hardware design meets their requirements. Question number 3. What innovations have you made? Companies like to hire employees who bring new ideas, innovations, and improvements to their organizations. The interviewer will ask you about your previous innovations to determine what you've contributed to the organizations you worked for in the past, and try to establish a metric such as money or time saved to determine its value. Having a story prepared for this question will enable you to demonstrate how you can help the company improve a process, reduce the time it takes to do something, or cut costs without compromising quality. In my last position, I noticed that my team was producing redundant documents which detailed similar aspects of a hardware development project. It occurred to me that each engineer was working in their own silo and was unaware of what other team members were focused on. I researched several collaboration tools and recommended to the management team how we could reduce redundancy, increase collaboration among the team, and shorten the time it took to design a piece of hardware. Management agreed to a trial of the systems. We found that the software would be effective in accomplishing each one of these objectives. The organization implemented the collaboration tool and realized immediate benefits. We were able to cut hardware development times by 25% and reduce the cost to develop a new piece of hardware by 15%. Question number 4. Walk me through your troubleshooting process when you are developing a new computer system. When interviewing candidates for a hardware engineering job, hiring managers prefer individuals who are analytical and are good problem solvers. The interviewer will ask you about your troubleshooting process to see the steps you take to identify the root cause of an issue and then resolve it. When troubleshooting an issue with one of my computer hardware designs, I start with the most logical and easy to fix issues. I test each one of my hypotheses, and if not successful, move on to the next one. Once I've exhausted these, I begin to think about some of the more unlikely causes. I consult several resources to locate these, including online documentation, manufacturer databases, and my notes. Finally, if I still haven't solved the problem, I work with the other computer hardware engineers on my team to leverage their knowledge and experience. This usually leads to resolving the issue. The last step is to document the solution so it can be easily resolved if it recurs. Question number 5. Can you discuss the difference between multiprocessing and multitasking? Multiprocessing and multitasking are both concepts used within a computer hardware system. While the terms sound synonymous, they are actually different. Knowing this and describing the differences to the interviewer will demonstrate your knowledge of microprocessors and the functions they provide within a computer hardware system. This enhances the interviewer's perception of your qualifications for this job. While multiprocessing and multitasking sound the same, they are different. Multiprocessing describes the ability of a central processing unit, or CPU, to execute multiple computer programs simultaneously. Computer hardware systems contain CPUs with multiple processors to enhance their multiprocessing capabilities. Multitasking is the ability of one processor, which can either stand alone or be one of several processors within a CPU, to switch between multiple programs that are running at the same time. Thank you for watching. If you found this video helpful, it'd be greatly appreciated if you could subscribe to our channel. It really does help motivate us to continue creating videos. Thanks again, and we hope you stick around to watch more interview practice videos from Mock Questions.